Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco and today I'm gonna be talking about window glass deflection. Now, what is deflection? Deflection is not the opposite of reflection, it's actually much simpler than that. So deflection is the bending of the glass on the window. So I bet you all seen effects like this, you see on the buildings when the glass is like bending and everything. Well, that is glass deflection. And it's actually very common for 3D artists to simulate that effect. But what I seen most of the 3D artists do is they just, you know, have their glass material and they just put noise in the bump or something like that and call it a day. But it's actually much more complex than that, and I'm gonna show you my approach on how I do glass deflection. So the render that I did is this, and this is a nice building that's provided by our lovely Evermotion, and this is their Archmodels volume 271, and this is the pack that's filled with skyscrapers. It's really cool and I encourage you to check this out. When it comes to lighting, it's of course Vermeer. Now let's see how I did this whole thing, and I'm gonna guide you step by step on what I did. So my material in final, it looks like this. So this is what we're gonna get in the end. But let's start from the scratch. So before we do anything, first select your glass object. I have two UVW map modifiers on it. The first one has box mode on it and it's map channel 1. And these are the dimensions, 6,000 centimeters, 6,000 centimeters, 6,000 centimeters. The second one is on face mode and it has a map channel 2. Since we're gonna do some masking here, you know, on the whole glass, it's important for me, and of course the glass is just a box object, I'm gonna be using this face mode. So the face mode will just stretch the texture, you know, across the whole polygon. And yeah, that's what we're gonna do. Another thing that I wanna set up, since I have a couple of cameras here, so I have this camera, this one, and I don't wanna switch between the cameras all the time by pressing multiple buttons here. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna activate my lovely pool scene manager here. And if I just do this click, I can just browse through my cameras like this, and it's easy as it is. I'm just gonna name these. So this is my main shot, sexy angle, telezoom shot, and the regular zoom. Okay, let's go to our main shot. Let me bring my render here. As you see, I have a clear white material on this. So let's make some glass. So first, I'm gonna crank up the reflection, crank up the refraction. Boom, you have glass. Next, we're gonna add some absorption. So you know how glass is usually like bluish or greenish? Well, we're gonna put some greenish color, something like this. And the absorption distance, let's try number 2. Okay, it's definitely too green. So, by the way, for those who don't know, absorption effect is the thicker the glass is, the more color it has. So this is the effect that we're trying to get now. So let's try 6 centimeters. Okay, maybe, you know what, let's go 8. Okay, 8 centimeters absorption. So now we have reflection, refraction, and absorption. And now we need to talk about the bump. The main property about glass deflection is, so you have a frame and you have a window, right? So window, you have glass, and then you have frame. Around the frame, that glass is always fixed. And you know, like the bigger the window is, like towards the center of the glass, it starts to bend. And this is the effect that you can see here. You can also notice how you have a similar type of bend near the corners here. Look at it, here, 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 but in the middle, it's always a different kind of bend. So we're gonna kind of simulate that by creating a mask where we are gonna ease up the bendings around the frame, but inside of the frame, we're gonna have a much stronger behavior. So let me just switch to my telezoom angle where we can clearly see the fronts of the windows. So, okay, let me just zoom in here. Now, first approach that I had, you need to put like a gradient, like radial gradient in it, but I didn't use the procedural gradient, and I'm gonna show you why. So I literally created a gradient map in Photoshop, literally like this. And I use that. And the reason for that is when you apply a classical gradient, and let me just set the type to be radial, map channel to number 2, that's our UVW map with a face mode. And if I plug that into my bump, you can see what's happening. You don't have that smooth, soft transition. It just, you have this kind of rough edge, and I tried actually smoothing out these somehow just to get, you know, like a smoother transition, but nothing worked. So I figured out that I'm gonna try and do it the other way. So I created a texture for it, and here's the texture. And now when I plug it in, now check this, just pay attention to these sharp corners. When I plug in the texture, you can notice how these corners suddenly became kind of blurry. And this is the thing. When I'm in FStorm bitmap, I think this is the thing with every rendering engine, you have the blurriness. So my FStorm bitmap has this pixel blur. I think with other rendering engines, it's just blur. I think the standard max is just blur. And so what I did, increased the pixel blur from 0 to 0.7. And this is the effect that we got. You can actually notice how much smoother this transition is. So now we got this corner areas, which practically have no noise, and the middle area where we're gonna fill it with noise. So with that being said, let's just put in a mix material, and we're gonna plug in the mask in our mix material, plug the mix to bump, and now we're gonna create noise. So for the noise, and let's plug it into texture one. I'm just gonna region render this central part. So I need to lower down my noise size. So my noise size, let's go to 1. Okay, we start to see some bending. Let's go 0.1. I mean, the biggest problem that we currently have is we still see that radial part from our map, and that's because this is a bump, and of course, you know, the black and whites here are affecting our bump. So what we need to do first, we need to go and shift this second color because it's pushing things out. We need to shift it down so that it kind of levels up. You see? So it levels up with the whole thing. Now you don't see the radial part, but you can feel that here or here, the noise is getting weaker, but in the middle, it's kind of more turbulent. Okay, let's go to our F-storm noise. So I'm just gonna lower down iterations to something like 3. So because that's gonna, you know, the higher the iteration, the more turbulent it's gonna be, the lower the iteration, the more smooth it's gonna be. And we got this. Okay, let's see if we can maybe put even lower noise. Okay, 0.5. Now there is a reason why I'm setting all this up in my telezoom lens, where my camera is actually super far away from the building and I am zooming in, you know, on a very, very small piece of the building. The reason I'm doing that, whenever you see buildings and, you know, these kind of deflection effects, you are always looking at them from afar. And because from afar, these effects are super pronounced. When you are like close to an actual window or something, you don't see it that much. I mean, it's there, you do feel the bending, but when you're super far away, then you can actually see how it looks like. And this is the point where you need to tweak your noise or your bump for your glass. Let me just go here in my top view. As you can see, the camera that we're using here right now is this camera here. And this is where our building is. Okay, let's continue playing with our bump. So if you take a look at this reference, for example, it's a very small defect. I don't want to, you know, be super crazy with it. I think this is a bit too much. You can actually see like the corners, they are like super turbulent. I don't think I want to chase that view. So I'm just going to go with something like this. So yeah, let's go 0.07. I think this is a similar kind of, when you look at it, this is like a similar form of deformation we have here. So I guess this works. Now, when I was tweaking this bump, I used a very high amount of bump. So this is 2 centimeter strength of a bump. And I used it because I wanted to just see, you know, how the main shapes look like, because in the end, we're going to lower this number down by a lot. So we don't want to see it that much pronounced. So the number that I'm going to use in the end is 5 millimeters. And this is the amount of deflection that I actually want to get. So yeah, I defined my shape, and this is the strength of the bump that I want to see from super far away. If I go to my zoom camera here, the zoom camera here is the camera that's literally 3 meters away from the glass building. Here you can see how strong the deformation is. Look at this. You can even see how much distorted this reflection is. And now look, when I switch to my zoom camera, you actually don't get that much distortion. And this is the real, you know, the real deal about it. Like whenever you are super close to any glass window like that, you don't see the distortion. But when you go across the street, you're always going to see, you know, the bendings and that stuff. And that's supposed to be your kind of, you know, main point on how to tweak the bump for it. Just tweak it from afar, because you're gonna, you know, you're literally tweaking your maximum value. Now let's just switch to our sexy angle that we used at first. Let's just see where we're at, like how far are we from our result. This looks generally okay. I mean, you can see the bendings everywhere. It looks nice. It's bending nicely. Even if you go to our main shot, it feels cool. You know, it's not too much. It is bending. It is deforming, but it's not a lot. But there's one part missing. So every glass on a window, there are not, so all the glasses, when you take them, you know, as a whole thing, they're always not perfectly aligned one next to each other. And those little tilts, we're talking literally one glass being, you know, like rotated like this by 1 millimeter, and the other is, you know, rotated by this by 1 millimeter. And all of the glasses have that tilt. And it's fascinating because up close, you can't see that tilt. But when you're far away, again, you see it. So take a look at here. So here you have the reflection of the other building, which is covering the whole window, but the window above it is practically clear. It's just seeing the clear sky. And this is a super, super tiny tilt that's happening. And those things are what makes, you know, window glasses like that look real. So we are going to add that effect. And I'm going to add that effect with one little script, which is called randomize elements. And this script comes as a modifier. I'm going to leave the links in the description for this script, but let me show you how it works. So you select your glass, right? These are all my windows on the whole building. I'm going to apply randomize elements. When you click it, press on generate button. And here you have the rotations. So look at this. If I go here and just increase my rotation, you see what happens. Each element is rotated separately. On the Z axis, it just goes left and right. So this is what we're going to use. We're going to use the X axis and the Z axis. Y is just tilting aside, which we don't want. And I don't want to, you know, use a lot of that. So again, let me just switch to my teleshot. And here I can clearly see how much things are going to be moving. So let's try this on one and this on one. Okay, so I think these windows are moving way too much. So let's go 0.5, 0.5. Okay, I think this generally works now. So as you can see, you had this, you know, line here, and here it continues to the left, here it continues more to the right. So I think this will produce a nice effect, and let's just see how that looks in our sexy angle. And this is the result. Now, as you can see, it looks very, very realistic. Now, take a look at the difference. If I turn it off, you can actually see how the whole thing kind of looks more straight. And here, I cloned this render in the frame buffer. So look at this. This corner, you don't have it here. Here, we have this balcony-looking reflection, which is doubled on these two windows. And if we go here, it's just a single one. So yeah, you get this broken effect. And I think that kind of, you know, gives a lot to the realism. If we switch to our main shot, and if I zoom in here, for example, you can clearly see, like, look at this. This reflection is pushed up. This one is pushed down. Then, you know, this one is up. This one is down. And this is the whole thing, you know, like this is the whole result. And I think you're going to gain a really, really cool effects with this. What's also important is this is a modifier. You can just turn it off and on whenever you want. So yeah, this is my approach on glass deflection. There is one other thing which I added in my original material, which I don't have here. I added, as you can see in the reflection slot and refraction slot, I actually added some sort of dirt. And this is the dirt. I'm not going to go in depth on what I did here, but it's actually this effect. So when I zoom in onto my window, you can see like the dirt around the windows. I mean, it's done the similar way. So it's just like a radial mask. Box gradient, where I just, you know, did I think this is like a concrete texture or something, you know, but it's just something to feel grungy. And yeah, this is the thing that's scattered around my whole scene. It's not that big of a deal of an effect. It's just that, you know, tiny kind of dirt around the glass. You can survive without it. But yeah, in general, this is how I approach my glass deflection. I hope you liked the video. Thank you for watching. Evermotion and Pools, thank you for sponsoring this video. Everybody, Pools is a new sponsor of RenderRam channel. See you in the next video. Bye.